Word. So yes. So a holiday horror story. Not. I mean, this is actually kind of great. I loved this tradition. But so for a long time, my family stopped celebrating Christmas. Or I mean, we're Jewish. We never really celebrated Hanukkah. There was one year we were all sort of talking, and nobody had any money for presents, and it just seemed silly. We wanted to do something. Also, my dad always worked on Christmas, so it was always like a thing, trying to actually get together on Christmas. So we were like, look, let's just choose a day somewhere between Christmas and New Year's, and we'll all get together and we'll just eat. We'll just have a potluck. You know, everybody brings food. And then we decided that it would be exclusively dishes made of meat. So we called this holiday Meat Fest, and we did it for like 12 years. As slowly as the holiday began to evolve, there would be like more and more rules that we sort of added in, right? That were just like four folks in the family, because the party kept getting bigger and bigger. I had friends who would come and hang out. And one of the rules of Meat Fest was that you had to invite anybody who you had been in a romantic relationship with, regardless of what terms you were on right now. You had to invite them. They did not have to come, but you had to extend the invitation in an act of sort of reconciliation. And so that led to, at times, very awkward situations at this holiday party. But the great thing about Meat Fest is you can't be that mad when you're eating that much steak. So it all worked out for the best. But there were definitely like a number of sort of like things that I think could have been holiday horror stories were it not for the presence of lots and lots of meat. We keep trying to bring it back. We're so spread out now, you know, the family's all over the place. But I would love to do it again sometime soon. Definitely do it. Definitely do it. Definitely keep that rule about inviting exes. And just have the most fun. It became like a competition for who could outdo each other, kind of, you know, in their meat dishes. So we had like, I had a friend make beef Wellington one year. I didn't know you could make beef Wellington. I had another friend who brought quail. Like really, like it became like this really sort of extravagant, like who can make the best meat dish. Over the course of this time, my mom became a vegetarian. My brother became a vegan, actually, so those holidays was like pretty whack for them too. But so we would start having like vegetarian options, which totally defeats the purpose. Whatever.